Really?
Say, for example, if you want to make like a small window.
You talk to Jacob upstairs.
Perfect. We can always adjust the scale.
So that's one thing.
And like, just look at
guys, so it is 9 minutes until we head out. So I like to tell you guys that we are not meeting next Saturday. We are meeting on February the 6th. So the next time we have class is February the 6th on Saturday. Because next week is the GBC Global Game Jam. And we're not going to have classes. It still runs throughout the same. We're still going to have 8 classes. So nothing's really changed. It's just we're not going to have class next week. So if we're going to resume class on February the 6th, we are not, our last week would be on, our last week would pretty much be on March the 5th. So it's been kind of like pushing back for another full week. since we only meet, like, every Saturday. But next week is an exception because of GBC Global Game Jam. And if you don't know what Global Game Jam is, it's basically you spend 2 days working on a full game. On a full game, whatever it is. Doesn't matter how small or big the project is. You can actually work, team up with a few developers and actually work on a game in 48 hours. And then you pretty much present it at the end of the full game. And that's it. That's what a game jam is. And pretty much at the end of it, you'll feel very sleep deprived and pretty much feeling like you're gonna throw up because you drink too many energy drinks. So anyways, so next week, I mean the week after, we're actually going to do kind of like an introduction to Photoshop, but more for texturing. And then also, I'm going to show you how to import assets into Unreal Engine 4 and Unity. And then pretty much the week after that, we'll dive into more level design with Unreal, and then we'll do like Weepsology. And then by March, you guys have a good environment for a good diorama to present at the end of this. So anyways, so it is 3:55. You can back up your stuff on Google Drive or Dropbox and pack up your stuff, and also don't forget your stuff either. So it is 3:56. This week we didn't see pack everything up. Oh, I almost forgot one. Well, we're on hiatus as well. This is completely optional. So what I'm holding in my hand is a Intuos Wacom tablet. I'm going to be using it for the Photoshop and ZBrush lectures for sure. For not just for sculpting, but also for texturing as well. We're going to be so if you guys have like a bamboo Wacom tablet, they're pretty much a sheet. You can pretty much get one, or if you do have one, that's great. Bring it. And that's what we'll be using. It's fine either way. It's completely optional if you want to bring one. Also, you can also search up on Ryan Kingsling as well. He's one of the creative minds behind ZBrush. Because he's been a professional sculptor all of his life. And he pretty much helped create ZBrush as it was today. So he's pretty big in the industry. In general. He's not only good when it comes to like the video game industry, but also in 3D in general. So he's a really, really good artist. So anyways, the Empire is shutting us down.
Alright, time to turn your game off. It's the end.
Really, that's the end now?
Oh my.
Yep. Alright, control